Hello everybody and welcome to a very special channel update video, because yesterday marked a very wonderful day for the history of my channel, mainly and purely because I accomplished something that I had always dreamed of doing, the next step of doing, since even before I had a YouTube channel set up. In case you didn't see it, whether, you know, this video is mainly just going to be for those people, but yesterday I uploaded, regardless of the footage, it was footage of Ratchet Deadlocked. But specifically, the main point was that it was a PlayStation 2 footage from my actual PlayStation 2 using the Elgato Game Capture HD, which I recently used, recently as in a year ago, to do PlayStation 3 footage. Now, that in and of itself was an accomplishment, because ever since I came to YouTube, the first things, when I first started watching gameplay on YouTube, they were Let's Plays of various games, and I always wanted to do those things, but as years and years went on, I never really understood how it worked, and when I did start learning about game capture cards, there was always so many, and everyone was always using different ones, I never knew which one to go with, and whenever I would finally pick one out, I would never actually get enough money to get it. This, of course, was finally, this finally happened in December 2016 when I got an Elgato Game Capture HD for Christmas, and I was so excited to use it, and that January, the next January of 2017, I sat down and for the very first time, I recorded test gameplay footage, I recorded a Let's Play on Ratchet & Clank on the PlayStation 3, and it was a dream come true. But in the back of my head, I always knew that the PlayStation 2 was going to be a console I really wanted to do gameplay of as well. That was where all of the games, when I would watch Sly Let's Plays and Ty Let's Plays and Ratchet and Jack Let's Plays, they were always the PlayStation 2 versions of the games, and I would always watch Let's Plays of other PS2 games. I never really watched all that many PlayStation 3 Let's Plays, because when I rolled around in that time period, I started to lose interest in actually watching new Let's Plays. But the problem with it is that the main reason that I was unable to actually ever record the PlayStation 2, let alone play it, because I haven't actually been able to play the PlayStation 2 religiously for, oh, who the hell knows, 10, 12, 13, 14 years. The last time I actually successfully played the PlayStation 2, like really sat down and played it, was when we first moved here, where I live now, which was in like 2005. Or 2006, and we had a TV set up in my room, but it was a really old TV. It was one of those really old, like with the curved, I don't know what they're called, but it has like a curved, what the hell, a screen, and it's a weird box, and it, you know, very old, very, very primitive. But one thing it could do was run all the retro consoles, the Super Nintendo, the PlayStation 2, all of that kind of stuff. And that's what I would sit in my room for days and days and play, was the PS2. Now, when I was even younger, when we lived at a different place using the same TV, I also played the PlayStation 2 religiously. However, it was not long after that we actually got a TV in our living room. It was a big, you know, big flat screen TV. Well, I wouldn't say big, but it was bigger than this tiny silver thing that I had. And that could also run, because it actually wasn't a high-definition TV. It could run the PlayStation 2 and all the retro. It couldn't run the Super Nintendo, though, because it didn't have the proper hook in, and we didn't have any adapters or anything. So I would often play the PS2 on that as well sometimes. However, when that TV died, we had to get a new one. And with this new one, we also got a monitor, a Sony PlayStation monitor. Both of these were high definition. This is where we ran into the first problem. Now, it was a problem that only I noticed because, well, old people. And it's a problem that some people might be like, well, why would you have that? Why is that an issue? Well, let me explain. Basically, I don't exactly know how it works, but essentially trying to play an old system on a new high definition TV causes issues. The image quality is crap, but it's not crap in the same sense that, you know, it's because you're trying to play a lower resolution on a bigger screen, because even if you resize it to what the game's actually made for, it still looks like utter garbage. One of the biggest things that I always found in recent years, you know, from 2016 and up, After doing research online to try and figure out how to fix this issue, I did research many years ago as well, but could never actually find fixes. One of the biggest things I would always notice from people in, you know, these threads is that, no, the quality isn't crap now, it's just you being an idiot because you think it used to look good, but it actually just looks like crap, period, and that's why it still looks like crap. People like this don't seem to understand, no, this is a different kind of crap, it is actually bad. It's bad to the sense where the reason I could hardly play, I could not play the games, period, because even text on the screen was ineligible. You couldn't read the text on screen. You couldn't read if there was a tutorial with text would pop up, or if there's a cutscene with subtitles, you couldn't read it. That is how pixelated it was. No, that is not the original poor quality of the PS2 at work. You could read text on the PS2 back in the day. You could read all the text. You could notice the details. When that is popping up as an issue, that is an issue. So I don't exactly know what causes it. I just know that it has something to do with newer TVs not really supporting the older consoles' resolutions and stuff like that, I guess. I don't know. Until I learned about component cables. And component cables aren't a 100% fit. The only way to actually get the best quality out of something like the PS2 is you're supposed to actually play it on an old TV. Well, that old TV I used to play the PS2 on, we actually still had about 5 years ago until we gave it away, of course. If I would not have let that happen if I knew that this was going to be a problem in the future. And the whole deal with it is that when I learned about component cables in 2016, actually, I don't know if I learned about component, I didn't learn about component cables until 2017, actually. When we, first of all, I was like, okay, so apparently what this does is it actually increases the image quality. It makes it a little bit more crisp, a lot easier to see. And, because I actually went and ordered my own TV. I don't know, August, September, something, 2017. I don't exactly remember when, but I ordered my own TV. It's a little TV. It's, I don't know. It's good size, but it's not TV size. It's like a little monitor. It just sits on a little stand, sits on the table right behind me. And I got it because I really wanted to do my own LPs. See, the problem was that I ran into is when I started doing the PlayStation 3 LPs, the PS3 was out in the living room, and, you know, when we had new neighbors that moved in, everything was just extremely, really difficult. I couldn't record when my parents were home. I couldn't record when my mother was off work because she'd be, you know, I couldn't do any recording. Only at specific times I'd have to wait for people to leave, and it was just a pain in the ass. So having my own TV in my own room would mean I could record whenever the hell I wanted to. Of course, though, I ran into other issues because merely days after I wanted to go and continue the Ratchet LP, it was cut short because I got sick. But after I got my own TV, and it's in the room now, one of the things I want to do was the first day we got the new TV is we hooked it up out in the living room just temporarily, and I hooked up the PS2 because I was super curious to know if for the first time in like a decade I'd be able to play the PS2. Loaded in a game, and the game we loaded up was Scooby-Doo Night of 100 Frights. And first things first, you know, the opening screens that come up with all the text, you know, like the warnings or, you know, the credits or whatever, the copyright, pops up. It just looks like a bland, you know, scribbled mess of yellow pixels. Can't make a single word out. Not a single word you can make out, except for the big Scooby-Doo text. That is it. Can't see any of the other text on the screen. And I tried pointing that out, but see, the thing with my parents was that they didn't exactly understand. They thought I was just being crazy, that there was no difference. Well, there is a difference. Can't read the damn text, can you? So that's when I found out, after doing research, about component cables. And we had to, you know, they went out to the store. They didn't sell component cables at Walmart, at Radio Shack. They didn't sell them at Best Buy. For some reason, no technology store sold any of these fucking cords. So we had to order them offline. Specific PlayStation or component cables actually made for the PlayStation 2. And they showed up, thankfully, within like a day or two, I remember. And got the TV out, unplugged the composite cables, and hooked the component cables into the PS2, loaded it up, same game, that same screen pops up with all the text, and suddenly you can make out every letter and you can see every fucking word on the screen. Got in and started playing the game a little bit, and sure, yes, here's the downside about component cables is they're not the best. They improve image quality on most games, not all games, though. Not all the games work with them. But you'll notice a lot of, like, jaggedy edges and stuff. It's almost like there's no anti-aliasing in work. But it works. It actually, you can see the fucking game. You can make out what the hell's going on, and you can actually play and enjoy it. And that is good enough for me, honestly. All the people online said it makes almost no difference, so there's no point. To me, it makes a world of a difference. And I tested it out with Ratchet Deadlocked last night. And the game, yeah, 480, actually the TV's running at 480i. It is a little bit to get used to. And yeah, it is a little, you know, sometimes a little hard to make things out in the distance, but with the component cables, after only a few minutes of playing, I was right into the game like I used to be. I didn't give a shit about the quality. I was just playing, and I was having a hell of a lot of fun. So what I did yesterday was I got really bored last night. I was super tired and really bored. I didn't have anything else to do, and I was free from War Thunder for like half an hour. And so I sat down and tried to see about hooking up the Elgato game capture card with the PS2. Now, I had already used the Elgato on the PS3. That's super easy to set up. It just takes a couple plugs, bam, done. I also actually figured out how to record the Super Nintendo Entertainment System Mini, or Classic Edition, on my own. Again, super easy to actually figure out how to do. So I did that as well. But the PS2 is a little bit of a different story. Because I'm using component cables, I had to look up some tutorials online, and none of the tutorials online actually showed how to use component cables with the Elgato. They all use either an adapter, or they use they either use composite with the component adapter, or they use this other cable that I have, but I don't know where it's at. But see, so the thing that I thought was that, okay, well, the Elgato comes with this adapter. It's got the white, red, blue, and green cables, which is exactly what component is. So I was thinking, well, then I just plug the component into the proper colors, right? I tried that. That was the first thing I tried. And I couldn't get any image quality. Nothing would come up on the screen. I hooked it into the HDMI slot as I'm supposed to. And I couldn't actually get anything to come up on the TV screen, though the game was coming up on the Elgato game capture card software on the computer. But I couldn't get the damn thing to come up on the TV. And I'm not, hell no, am I going to be playing it through the software, because there's like a 1 second delay, and that's way too much in an action game like this. So I had to turn around and try and prod and poke. And I was a little frustrated because I couldn't figure out exactly what the hell the problem was. I'd followed the tutorials as best as possible, and I tried it out. So I was like, well, if it's coming up on the software, but not on the TV, what's wrong? Now, keep in mind, yes, I did switch through all my HDMI channels on the TV to make sure, you know, to go to the right slot. So what I did is I unplugged it and plugged it into the next HDMI slot, and suddenly it works. So for some reason, the other HDMI slot doesn't work, but this other one does. I think I've got four different HDMI slots for the TV. And the slot number one doesn't work, but slot number two does. I don't know why. That makes no sense to me, but I got it to come up. First thing that happens is all of the quality is green. The game is just green. Everything is green. And I was like, oh, something's not right. And the image was actually kind of flickering, almost like, you know, those old film strips that you'd see from way back in the day. And I was like, something's not right here. So I went to the cables, and I unplugged the red from the slot that it was in and replaced it with the other red and just swapped them around, and bam. I did the same with the white ones as well, and suddenly it was working perfectly fine. The audio was coming in, and the picture quality was the color, was, you know, the colors it should be. It makes no sense with the way that the component cables are actually set up, but apparently you have to tangle the cords to actually get the proper image quality. So I don't even know if I'm doing it right, but I managed to actually get it to work. I sat down, pressed the record button, and that was literally the first time me playing Ratchet Deadlocked in years, 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 and years, and years. That's why I was pretty shit at the game, because I didn't know what I was doing. And it was so much fun to play the PS2 again. It felt so freaking good. And I wanted to do the video so that I could upload it and say, hey, look, here's a test video. What's the quality like? So the software is picking it up in 480p. That is what YouTube is actually uploading it in 480p. It's being recorded in 480i. I don't actually know the difference between it. Now I have progressive scan turned on for Ratchet Deadlocked. It makes the image quality a little bit more crisp. And one thing I did notice was that, I don't know if it's because I had widescreen turned on or something, but I went and watched somebody else's video and of their Ratchet Deadlocked gameplay of the PS2, and it basically looks like the exact same quality. So it looks like I'm on the right track. However, one thing I noticed is, like, when they load into a new area, you know that staple in Ratchet games where when you first load into a level and they show you that big open view of the level? Whenever that happened in his video, you could see Ratchet in the corner. You could make him out, he's fully standing there, but in my video, Ratchet's not there. Because it's like the resolution, you know, or the aspect ratio isn't right. So Ratchet's cut off until I actually start playing. So I gotta tweak around with the settings on some games, I guess, and see if I can't find the proper ratio versus, you know, resolution to actually make sure that everything's on the screen and not cut off. The only other thing I noticed was that there's a buzzing in the audio. It's not coming from the TV. I can only hear it through the Elgato game capture, so it must have something to do with the component cables through the adapter, I guess, because I don't hear it when I'm playing. It's not coming from the TV or the game. It's only when recording it in the software. Now, the buzzing is very light, and you can't hear it when the game's actually playing. When music and gunfire and all that stuff's happening, you know, cutscenes, you can't really hear it. You only hear it when it goes silent. It's just this bzzz. That's exactly the same sound that the old TV I used to play the PS2 on made. It made that sound all the time. I kind of think it adds to the effect. I might just leave it in just to make it feel a little more nostalgic. Now, I didn't get many comments on the video. I didn't expect to. I mean, this isn't exactly what my channel is known for, unfortunately, despite being an LP, heavily LP-driven channel. I did end up getting a couple comments, and a lot of them talking about nostalgia. And one of them saying that I have to play through the game and 100%, and I was like, yeah, that's the plan. I'm just trying to find out if this was the proper quality, if this is acceptable. Now, watching it in full screen is a little bit... but watching it on a small or in large screen actually works, in my opinion. It doesn't hurt. And it really reminds me of how I often go back and watch old Let's Players, the LPers that I watched back in the day, where the quality isn't good. It's bad quality for today. But I still love watching it. The quality doesn't bother me one bit. That's how I felt when I was watching the video that I made. The only thing I didn't test, however, was a microphone, because since I don't have my old... On the PS3, when I was recording that Ratchet & Clank game, I was recording with my headset, my Turtle Beach's headset microphone, which was easy to do. It blocked out background noise. This microphone that I'm using here does not block out background noise. In fact, you can probably hear me just tapping my keyboard slightly. The problem is the way that I play, or the way that I did play, was I would wear my headphones so that I could... Well, okay, let me see if I can remember how I did this. Because I was talking through my headset, my microphone, but I was wearing the headphones, the software will actually play the audio from the game. But the problem is because the software is delayed, you will hear delayed audio. So you're going to see something on the screen, but the sound's not going to happen for a second or two. So what I would do is I would wear the headphones, turn the microphone on, speak through it, but I would mute the PC so that I couldn't hear it, and then I would barely turn up the game on the TV ever so slightly so that I could hear the game through the TV, just slightly, but not loud enough to the fact where you hear double of the game. You see what I'm saying? I don't need these headphones when I'm playing and recording, honestly, because I'm not using them for anything. All I need is the microphone in front of me. But the problem is the microphone picks up on a lot of background noise. So I don't know how loud the TV can go before the microphone starts picking up on it. That's the only problem I'm going to have. So I'm going to have to run some tests that I probably won't upload to YouTube. I'll just do my own side tests for that. And that's the kind of thing I'll have to be checking for. Let's see, what else? It's all set up back there right now. I left it all set up because I didn't want to tear it apart because it was a pain in the ass to actually get running anyways. This doesn't mean that I'm going to sit down and start like LPing Ratchet Deadlocked or anything. I'm still wanting to do them in chronological order as best as possible. So, you know, I'm going to be going back to the PS3 versions first and then coming to Deadlocked after I finish the first three. you know, something like that. I just wanted to, I was so bored, I wanted to test it. And I might even run another test today on another PlayStation 2 game, like Scooby-Doo or something, just to see what different games look like on the, excuse me, on YouTube. See if they look like shit, or if they look basically the same, or, you know, something like that. Because I need it to at least be acceptable to the point where you can at least see what's happening and know what's going on, something along those lines. Now, the deadlock that I actually ran yesterday was, I would like to say a new copy that my dad ordered off eBay late last year. I went and ordered, we went and ordered some Ratchet games off eBay. Two, I think. Was it two? I think it was two, or it was three or something like that. Oh, wait, no, it wasn't two. Shit, where are the games at? Yeah, we ordered Full Frontal Assault, because I didn't own that one. And then we ordered another copy of Ratchet Deadlocked, and then Secret Agent Clank for the PS2. Now, we already had all Ratchet games except Full Frontal Assault. I had a Ratchet Deadlocked, but we ordered a new one because the other one is so heavily used that it's so scratched up that back in the day when I would play it, it would freeze and crash almost constantly. And I have an interesting story to tell about that when I go to do my Deadlocked LP. Because there was a way that I could actually break the game. And it was so interesting, the way that you could do it, how I could progress by basically just... Yeah, I'll tell that story in the future. And got Secret Agent Clank because I have that for the PSP. But I wanted the PS2 version. I also wanted Size Matters for the PS2. Because I have that for the PSP. Unfortunately, that one was more expensive than any of the other games. So this copy that I actually recorded the gameplay of was from the new copy. And I say quote-unquote it was new because it came fully wrapped. Right? Like, you know, like you would buy it out at the store and it comes fully wrapped. But I almost feel like somebody just kind of... Hello? Oh, right. I was looking... Okay, I'm sorry. I forgot that I increased the size. Never mind. Fuck that. I got mistaken there. I almost feel like somebody kind of tricked and rewrapped it themselves, because when I opened it and opened the case was broken, so it wouldn't snap shut. One part snapped shut, but the other doesn't. And inside, you know where the manual usually sits? There's those two clips on the inside of the PS2 case. One of the clips is missing entirely. It snapped off, and it's missing entirely. It's not even floating around in the case. It's just gone. Curious. And I looked on the disc, and the disc is pretty clean, but there's a smudge, a tiny smudge on the edge, which is also curious. So I just feel like it was a little, you know, sort of deal. But I don't care. At least I've got another copy of the game now. What else? Shoot, there's a whole bunch that I wanted to say, and I'm almost forgetting about it. I don't know when I'm going to be doing tests. I don't want to do tests of... Shit, something's about two in my ass. I don't want to do more, like, tests, like, microphone tests and all that right now. And I'll be doing more of those tests. I'll just do basic gameplay tests for now. But I'll do the microphone tests after the whole War Thunder event blows over so that I actually have more free time. Because right now the only reason I have free time is because I managed to do the tasks, or one task really early, so I have plenty of time to do the other one, so I'm taking a little break. It only took me 8 matches to do the ground task, which was freaking amazing. That was a ton of luck that actually went into that. So, yeah, I'm very happy to see that there are a few people that are excited to see PS2 gameplay. And like I said, this is a dream come true, because the ability to not only play the PS2 again but record it is so crazy. So freaking crazy. Now, I officially brought Ratchet and Clank on the PS3 to a close. In the LP, I said I wanted to try and 100% it. Get all the gold bolts, all the gold weapons, and get the rhino and all that kind of stuff. I never did. And that's because I ended up getting sick and I never went back to the game. However, I went back a few months back when I was looking at over my unfinished LPs. I went back to the game and I went into my Let's Play section on my channel and I went to the final episode and I retitled it to Finale, and I posted in the comments that this is officially the end of the LP with the possibility of bonus videos. I don't like that. I keep thinking back to that and I keep thinking that that is just... It's unsatisfying. So I'm actually thinking about unplugging the PS3 and bringing it in here into the room. And in my spare time between tasks, I'm actually going to play some Ratchet on the PS3. I'm going to bring up that old save file, if it still exists, that I had for my LP. And I'm going to play through the game until I get enough bolts that I'm going to do one final bonus video or two different bonus videos where I finally buy all of the golden weapons after finding all of the gold bolts and showing off the rhino and all the weapons and stuff. That way I can actually bring it to a close. The only thing I won't be doing is all of the skill points. That's probably the only thing in all of the series that I'm not going to be doing. But then I can finally move on to the second game in the series, which I am dying to do. I've been dying. I've been kind of on this little bit of a ratchet itch recently. I want to play the Ratchet game so bad, but freaking War Thunder is in the way. If War Thunder wasn't pissing on us right now, I'd be playing Ratchet and Clank and recording it right now. Right now, I'd be speaking about Ratchet, not about Ratchet. So yeah, I plan to actually come back and fully finish that original first before I move on to the second, and then I'll be doing that. So you might be wondering, well, why don't I play the PS2 versions of the original games? Because the thing with the trilogy is that on the HD remaster is that it's kind of botched. They're a little bit glitchy, specifically in like the cutscenes. Well, I prefer, the game itself is still actually really, really good. So I actually play the PS3 versions, and I would rather play those over the PS2 versions. Now, when it comes to Deadlocked, I'm going to be doing the PS2 version and not the PS3 version. Now, I don't own Deadlocked on the PS3 because it's only digital. It's not actually physical. I like to own the physical copies of Ratchet and Clank if possible. And the only other problem is that I have seen gameplay of Deadlocked on the PS3, and it is awful. The game itself, again, is actually pretty good, but the cutscenes are even worse than I could have ever imagined. They're so botched. I don't know how they could have let something like that actually sell. But apparently it does. I would rather play the PS2 version and deal with 480p quality than play a high-definition glitchy fest, in my personal opinion. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm not sure about the Secret Agent Clank and Size Matters, because from what I've heard, those actually don't have progressive scan and they don't have high quality because they're meant for the PSP, so they might look like utter shit on video when I try and go and record those. You know, and we'll slowly work our way up through the future series and then the spin-off titles, and then until we finally make it up to the PS4 re-release, reimagine of Ratchet and Clank, which I have never played. In fact, my copy is not even unwrapped yet. It still is unopened. I've heard good and bad things about it, but it will definitely be a blind LP, probably the first Ratchet blind LP. However, I think for right now, I'm actually going to sit back and try and record some other games on the... I might record like 3 or 4 different games over the course of the next few hours on the PS2 just for test videos, and then I'll run the test... Excuse me. And then I'll upload some of the test videos over the course of the night. So I'm going to do Scooby-Doo. I might try Spyro, Hero's Tale, and then there's probably a few others I might want to try as well. So otherwise, other than that, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next channel update video. I am very happy right now. I'm so freaking happy.